it's the home of the Suns here in Phoenix, Arizona, as 2K Sports brings you today's live action from the U.S. Airways Center. Welcome, everyone. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, as we get set to bring you some terrific NBA action. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. And guys, taking a look at Klay Thompson, what will we see from him, do you think, today?
You know, Kev, he brings something to their team that they've needed more than a few times, that instant offense, the burst, you know, one or two baskets in a row and he's off to the races. That's such a valuable trait for a team to have.
And Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, I caught up with Z for a bit. There has been some talk of late that there is some friction between he and his teammates over how much he calls for the ball. I asked him about it. He said, if there is any, I hope it can be put to rest at some point. We're all on the same team trying to reach the same goals. We'll see if they can iron out their issues, guys.
You say some of the things he said, and it's no surprise to see him frozen out.
Now, some of the comments that he made were really unforgivable. You just don't say stuff like that about your teammates.
Barnes, he's checked in for Andre Iguodala. Five on the clock. On its way from Curry for two. Misses off the left iron.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Here's Newman, guarded by Curry. And he nails it. The three-pointer falls for Morris. Morris has got himself on the board with three there.
Looked like there was a little confusion there as to who was supposed to be guarding him.
Crawford gets a screen from Green. Crawford kicks to Green. Down low. Tries to keep it alive. Wants to get it to Spades and does. Right wing. On its way from Curry for two. Another miss by Curry.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
Rejected by Barnes. And so it looks like the Suns will retain possession here. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. Take a look at the Suns. They're in the upper part of the conference records right now. In fifth place. And of course, Golden State down four spots from them.
Checking out Phoenix. They've hit the ground running to start this young season, and I mean that literally. Raising some eyebrows with their hot start so far.
Yeah, the start of the season, you know, it's a time when optimism is league-wide. The early play of this club certainly provides for some real proof that this could be a good team. They've looked awfully good.
Here's Blake. He's covered by Newman. Second chance shot. No good off the back of the rim.
Looked like he rushed that one, guys. The defense was out of position. He was wide open, just couldn't take advantage.
To the paint. Here's Barbosa, rejected by Barnes. Crawford outside. Crawford missing again. The scoring fast and furious as we end the first quarter. Warriors lead by five. 2K Sports, back in a moment here from the U.S. Airways Center. The second quarter beginning in just a moment. And look at how the hustle game has been going for the Warriors.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor.
Also, we've seen them have active hands on the defensive end. They're putting a lot of pressure on the ball and coming away with some steals.
Newman, he's in a shooting guard. Okafor out there with Channing Frye. Then there's Bledsoe, and it's Green in at the small forward. So that's the Suns' five as we get into the second quarter. A chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Well, Z in the last matchup against the Kings played some outstanding basketball. He ended with 16 points, and he was a thief out there as well, adding a hefty amount of steals to his total. He seemed to be everywhere on the floor the entire time and really was the star of the show, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thank you. He played at a level that very few players are capable of playing for.
Yeah, I agree. I was just glad I got a chance.
.103 left in the first half of the game. Newman, the pass to Okafor. Drops in the layup for two. Okafor's got his first points of the game.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
Yeah, it's a strategy that has served them well in this opening half, Clark.
Newman, the pass to Okafor. Here's Newman, covered by Barnes. Here's Newman. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the layup. Make him earn it at the line.
The Warriors making a switch here. O'Neal's checked in. Both free throws good from Newman.
And the free throws are starting to pile up a little bit here, more so than in the first quarter.
And that's one of the reasons they're in front right now.
Crawford drives in. He dishes it to O'Neal. Rejected by Newman, and he's able to get it back.
You know, even though they're behind, I love the job they've been doing getting to the free throw line.
Yeah, they've been aggressive, and that's really important. You've got to continue to attack.
The Warriors have made 5 of 8 of their free throw attempts.
As a team, they're down there around 72% from the stripe.
Yeah, it's been a very frustrating season for them in that regard, guys.
And he knocks down the first one. Both free throws good from Crawford. There's 25 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Here's Newman, guarded by Kerr. Newman, the pass to Okafor, and he gets the bucket. Okafor's got the lead up to 3 now for the Suns.
Well, it's easier to protect. You can get nice high percentage shots rather than settle for long three-pointers that they did in the first quarter.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, shooting percentage a function of shot selection. I think they've got to keep the pressure on each possession, and I think that's easy to do when you're attacking the paint and not settling for threes.
And the first half ends in a close one. Phoenix ahead, leading by a point. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, David, you got out of the gate strong. Was it important for the team to come out and have a confident first quarter after the loss in the last game?
We tried to make up for last game and tried to make up for it. I tried to just be as aggressive as possible to start the game, and our defense really, really helped us in the first quarter.
David, thank you. Guys, this is a team that won't hang its head.
Thanks, Doris. And, folks, the halftime show is coming up next, and then it's on to the third quarter. We'll step aside right now.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Welcome to 2K Sports. It's been a great Sunday of basketball so far. At U.S. Airways Center, the Suns in a close one against Golden State. They're sitting in fifth place in the conference and trying to edge their way upward. Nice ball movement offensively, making the extra pass, and it's paying off. On the other hand, Golden State also been giving it their best. Defensive pressure so far, paying off. They're forcing miscues, ripping and running. And that's all we got for you here in the studio. Time to send you back out to Kevin, Steve, Clark, and Doris for the start of the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Looking at the last game for the Golden State Warriors, it was a loss to the Rockets.
And Kevin, when you don't take advantage of your trips to the free throw line, which they definitely did not, it's tough to recover from.
It sure is. I mean, they left a lot of cheese and lettuce at that foul line.
Not to mention some ham and turkey, but.
And Golden State looking at who they've got. On the wing, Thompson and Iguodala. David Lee is out there with O'Neal, and it's Curry in at the point.
You know, guys, Emeka Okafor was the number 2 overall pick out of Connecticut back in 2004. And because he was drafted so high, some people may have expected more. But I always saw him as what he's become. A physical, bruising big man inside who can rebound his position and do the little things to help you win. And he's done that consistently and effectively throughout his career.
Green, the pass to Newman. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there. And Emeka Okafor, really a bodybuilder's physique, 6'10", well over 255 pounds. you know, physically, he's always been the perfect picture in terms of how he conducts himself, how he readies for a season.
Yeah, he's got that chiseled frame that actually reminds me a little bit of you, Jeff.
Well, thank you,
although
Steve.
He stands almost 7 feet tall.
No, you're... I'm 6'2".
Yeah.
But it's so kind to say.
Sure.
I appreciate that.
You know, guys, we had seen what Curry, as the focal point of the team's offense, was capable of, but in a full year with no Monte Ellis by his side, Curry really showed what he could do on the basketball court, and it's special.
The Warriors making a switch here. Spates has checked in.
He's far too tentative in the paint, and even more so when the defender is up tight on him like that time.
And keeping us updated from the start, swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Yes, gentlemen, last season the Golden State Warriors vastly exceeding expectations, and they did it all while playing their rookies extensively. The young guns showed a great maturity and work ethic from the start, leading the Summer League team to an undefeated record. With Festus Ezeli and Draymond Green, both four-year seniors, Harrison Barnes said that as the youngest in the pack, being around those two helps me mature more quickly. And guys, they delivered quickly, helping the Warriors reach the second round of the playoffs.
Thanks, Doris. And this team poised not just to win, but to win big for years to come.
You got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
And for the Warriors, you know, you talk about that Monte Ellis trade. A big part of that move was getting the ball into the hands of Stephen Curry.
That's right. And also to get Klay Thompson on the floor as the starting two. It really balanced out that Warriors roster, but it allowed Curry to become the star that he is. He's so good offensively. He's got the total package. And I think when you look at this Warriors roster, it's a bright future.
That backcourt, Steve, is about as good a shooting backcourt as I can recall on one team.
With range? Yeah, I agree. I've never seen anybody better.
Here's Newman. Kicks it to Okafor. Curry with the defensive effort. And there's a whistle. That goes on Z. That is his first foul of the game. Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Crawford against Barbosa. Crawford kicks to Blake. In low to Lee. Good. And the assist goes to Blake. 25 points for David Lee.
And defensively, they're starting to look for answers because ever since halftime, they've been disjointed out there.
Shot from 16. Newman with the bucket.
Newman!
Here's Crawford, averaging 13 points a contest. Out to the right wing. Blake dishes to Lee. Tries from 10, and it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
David Lee, such a versatile big man. He rebounds, he can pass from the high post. He's got that mid-range jumper, and he can finish inside with either hand. Little hook shots, flip shots. He is a really, really good player.
And guys, you mentioned David Lee's ambidextrous finishing. I mean, Steve, he actually broke his left arm when he was in high school, and it forced him to develop his right hand in the meantime, and that's why he's so effective with both hands, and he's really made the most of it. It's part of what makes him a tough guy to deal with.
Right side, Lee. Ball's not loose.
And no need to rush it. They can play for one shot.
And I think they should wait till about the 5-second mark to go for it. You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Green kicks to Crawford. Blake for three. It's hauled in by the Suns. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
You know, they had a great start to that game. The guys got hot early, and it seemed to become contagious. Everybody started shooting the ball well at that point.
You know, typically, if there's a hot shooter, the defense can make an adjustment and lean everything towards stopping him and let somebody else beat you. But that wasn't an option in that game.
And the Warriors making a change here. For Phoenix, they have made 7 out of 9 when they've stepped to the line.
Yeah, they've just been an ordinary team in terms of free throw shooting this year, guys, about 75%.
You know, they've really put themselves behind the eight ball in so many of their games because they just have not been able to knock down those foul shots.
And the game still closely contested as we end the third quarter. Suns lead by 2. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. And we've reached the end of the third quarter. Just a terrific game so far. In a moment now to check out our State Farm assist of the game, and what a pass it was by a talented point guard.
Well, this is what he does. This is the kind of plays he's known for, Kevin.
The Suns leading, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the fourth quarter. On the court for the Suns, Newman, he's in at point guard. Green is out there with Goodwin. Then there's Channing Frye, and it's Bledsoe in at shooting guard. Frye passes to Goodwin. Here's Newman. Great D that time from Thompson.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Fast break, here come the Suns. The coast-to-coast dunk.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Here's Nedovic. Thompson outside. Here's the dish to O'Neal. Lays it up and banks it in. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Here's Newman, defended by Nedovic. Out to the right wing. Passes it to Newman. Six on the shot clock. Free throw line jump shot. And the shot no good, a bit short. The Warriors trail. It's Thompson off the drive. Here's O'Neal. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And at this stage of the game, that offensive rebound and putback is enormous. I mean, that feels like a four-point swing.
Here's Newman, defended by Nedovic. Pass to Frye. That's good. And the Suns lead by two.
He's been key for this team's offense, the way he's distributed the ball.
Yeah, you know, the offense is just moving through him, Steve. No doubt.
Out of it. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Bledsoe. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. Emeka Okafor, he's checked in for Phoenix. Rogic comes in for Eric Bledsoe.
After the 2004 realignment of the divisions, the Suns jumped out quickly and secured the Pacific title a few times, but even in their long stretch as one of the top teams in the West up until the last few years, they've waited a long time to win another Pacific title.
I don't know if it's just me, but he's looked a step slow since the start of the quarter. His shooting has really suffered.
Thompson with it, now guarded by Dragic. Thompson dishes to Iguodala. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. Well, the last Suns division title coming in 2007. And with the way the rest of the division has buffed up, Steve, their roster is now looking very strong. The Suns were forced to rebuild, and now it may take a while.
Yeah, that's true. The division is getting tougher all the time with Golden State and the Clippers getting better. The Lakers, you know, are going to bounce back quickly. But the Suns have a strong history, one of the great records in NBA history as a franchise. In fact, fourth highest winning percentage of all time after the Lakers, Celtics, and Spurs.
Jermaine O'Neal checked in for Nedovic.
And he's doing a great job at the charity stripe. It's easy to overlook, but those freebies can make the difference.
Outside, Curry fires the three, tries again, and there's the layup. Count the bucket from O'Neal. O'Neal's got six here in this quarter.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Here's Okafor. He drains the turnaround jump shot. Okafor's got the lead up to four now for the Suns. Warriors have gone 3 of 6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Here's Curry. Okafor with the block. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Iguodala with the block. Curry attacking. Blocked. Out of bounds. Phoenix will take possession. And the Suns call time here.
It's like he saw some things out there that needed adjusting and wants to talk it over a little bit with his club.
I don't think you can ever go wrong burning a timeout if you see something you don't like and you need to talk about it.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Yes, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Jeff Hornacek as he addressed his team. He told the guys that for now, he wants to see them back off the three-point shot, saying all our offense doesn't need to come from perimeter jump shots. Let's get the ball inside for some high-percentage looks.
Thanks again, Doris. He was all alone on that one.
He's too dangerous a shooter to leave alone behind the arc.
Guys, we have seen them with a lot of good ball movement.
Well, you like the smooth operating they're showing you here. I mean, things are clicking, and more importantly, it makes them tough to defend.
You know, there's no agenda, and the ball's just moving to whoever is open. And as a result, they've kind of developed a clicking pace to their game. It's been fun to watch.
This is a dual knee. 1:24 left in the fourth quarter. Over to the wing. Just five to shoot. Outside for Curry. Thompson with it. Now guarded by Dragic. Newman, the pass to Dragic. That's blocked. And here we go. Thompson heading to the hoop. Clark and Steve, neither team with a big advantage here in the fourth quarter.
Five times we've had the lead switch so far. I mean, back and forth we go.
Yeah, and I think that total could rise, Clark, because two evenly matched teams playing a tough game.
Here's Newman. There's the screen. Off the pick.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
51 seconds left in the game. Outside Curry. Misses the tray. Absolutely critical chance right here.
Yeah, they need this one to go their way, Kevin. Oh, that is a massive shot.
You know it is. He's stepping right into the spotlight.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Well, it's still within reach.
Yeah, but their offense, Steve, needs to be just about perfect from here out.
Connects! And that shot brings them to within just one.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days. Finger work.
And so they choose to intentionally foul. Clark, a big-time possession here.
Tell you what, their hearts have to be racing right now.
And they go to the intentional foul. Good on the first, and that will put them up by two. So both free throws are good, and it's a three-point game.
And the free throws make things a lot more simple for them. Now you just have to guard against the three-pointer.
Iguodala outside. Good! And, oh, that was an enormous three-pointer.
Boy, he quieted the crowd with that big shot. That's a big play.
Yeah, the crowd's been hoping for something to cheer for, but nothing.
Here's the screen. Here's Newman. Oh, and a chance to win the game, but the last second shot is offline. Regulation is ended, and we're heading to overtime. 2K Sports, back in a moment here from the U.S. Airways Center. And what great competition we're seeing so far. After four quarters, a stalemate, and we'll see now how these two teams and these few minutes of basketball pan out. Courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineup for us now in overtime. And Phoenix looking who they've got on the floor. Newman in at point guard. Gerald Green out there with Channing Frye. Then there's Dragic, and it's Okafor in at the five. Crawford against Dragic. Now here's Crawford, tight defense on him. Got a piece of it. The feed now to Kerr. Five to shoot. Shot tonight. And they'll keep possession. And the whistle blows as the basket counts. And a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Well, how about David Lee in this one? 11 rebounds.
So we see the Warriors taking the game here. And impressive.
Congratulations on this win tonight, Steph. And then tell us a little bit about the driving philosophy behind how this team strives to be the most cohesive unit possible.
To me, it's a commitment. We know that that's going to, you know, put us in good position to win every single night. Is if we bring the effort, multiple efforts at each possession, where you might get beat, but you got to get back in the play. And God's going to help you. You help him. You know, we care about each other, so we want to make sure that nobody's left out to dry. And I think that's a big factor. And you know, we're just relentless on defense. Win.
Congratulations, Steph. Great job, guys. Over to you.
Thank you, Doris. And, folks, that about concludes our broadcast tonight. For Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching as we leave you with our Jordan Player of the Game, David Lee. Section, heaven's